Steve Moran here with Senior Housing Forum, and today I'm talking to my friend Valerie Whitman, who is with LeadingResponse, a great Senior Housing Forum sponsoring partner. And a number of weeks ago, we did a webinar where we talked about doing event-based marketing activities to reduce the cost of move-ins for senior living communities. And one of the participants in the webinar asked a question that I kind of scratched my head on, and I didn't know the answer to. I hadn't really thought about. But usually these events are targeted at consumers. But the question was, have you ever done an event-based marketing activity that is focused very specifically on referral sources? And so I've asked Valerie to talk a little bit about that today.
Sure. So the answer is yes, we do. We can target professionals. You know, there's typically a handful of titles that you want to focus on. You know, the financial advisors, LDR attorneys, we all know kind of who those folks are. And essentially what we're trying to do there is have it be still an educational seminar. You don't necessarily want to have just your typical, cocktail hour like many people do to attract professional referrals. You know, in 15 years of doing this, I've come across many professionals that have said, you know, I can eat out about four nights a week if I just go to every single senior living event that I get invited to, right? And so you want to try to avoid that. You want to, of course, be unique from what everyone else is doing. The CEU events, those are pretty easy, right? You know that those are a target audience of typically the clinicians that need those CEUs. But aside from that, really you want there to be that opportunity for the referrals to also meet other referrals where they have potential to get more business. And so if you think about those various companies that you have in your market that you want to basically get together and be the host and the platform of getting them together, is also an opportunity for them to mingle, but also an opportunity for you to make sure that everyone knows about your community, if there's something new you're offering, or, you know, you've got a five-star rating with your reviews, or, you know, deficiency-free, whatever it might be that you want to kind of get out to the masses. And you can do that in a similar ways that you do with the consumers, you know, hosting the two dates that gives the professional the option of which works best for them. You can host one on-site. You could host both on-site. You know, the professionals aren't as concerned in terms of interacting with your brand on site. They know about senior living. They've typically been in your communities before. But you do still want to give them the option of offsite as well. So maybe it's a combination of onsite and offsite, or it's both onsite. And essentially giving them a lot of education, but still in that short amount of time, 20 to 30 minutes max is what we recommend for the presentation. And then it's, allowing them to make 20 to 30 minutes.
Okay.
Of a presentation.
Right. And then, so do you typically have about the same number of people show up for an event like that as you do when it's prospects, or more or less, or different?
Great question. Yeah, it's definitely different because when you think about the target audience in your primary market, let's say a 10-mile radius, you have many more consumers that meet the demographic criteria, especially when you're looking at adult children and seniors. So for professionals, you're only going to have typically about 30 to 40% that you would on the consumer side. There's only so many of them out there. So typically you'd go out about 20 miles. And so that way you're in your secondary market. You can still get referrals from case managers at the hospital two towns over, type of thing. And you're looking at, more like 30 to 50 RSVPs than you would be upwards of 100 or more on the consumer side.
Terrific. That's actually really, really helpful. But it sounds like it makes a lot of sense to at least occasionally do an event that is focused on those referral sources.
Right, especially if the referral sources you've been focused on are giving you referrals few and far between, because you can only go back to them so many times, right? I mean, there's only so many opportunities for them to refer to you, plus they're going to be referring to other folks as well. That might be home care, it might be senior living, might be your competitors. So being able to really get a better sense of how many other professional referrals are out there, and that's what we found with our clients that will do these. They'll say, wow, I didn't realize there were this many in my primary or secondary market, and yes, I definitely want to, invite them and be introduced to them.
Cool. Well, listen, thank you very much. I appreciate that. That provides great clarification. Thanks.
Thank you.